Okay, now that we have inflated our tire with the compressor, you just gotta make sure whenever you're using it, like I said before, keep your hands clear of the sides, and don't forget to use some Windex, some lubricating. You have to square it all around the sides. So when you're applying the air pressure, the tire has enough doesn't have resistance, so you can expand easily. Now we're gonna start applying lubricating the pieces. There's a couple of them in the middle. You know, just take some grease and start, you know, rubbing it in the areas that are gonna be rotating. Also, get some. Remember to use some waterproof grease for the bearings and all the interior parts. See, all you have to do is just, you know, smear the stuff in. You know, the whole point is to keep the bearings and, you know, basically all the areas that are gonna have a lot of friction from rotation well greased. That's the whole point of the grease. Now you have the shocks right here on the wheel. All you have to do is just, you know, fit it back in.
What about those?
You sh you fuck. Now all you have to do is, of course, don't forget the rest.
Yeah,
I
you're
was just
putting it
trying. I
halfway.
was just seeing if you could. It does
This
fit.
part is what not to
No,
do,
it
what
does.
not to forget.
No, it does fit, so it's okay. So keep in mind, I have these two, these other two parts. One goes in the inside, one goes on outside. And you do the same thing. I kind of cleaned up the, I cleaned up the pieces. So you just, you know, just all you have to do is just rub some a little bit in it.
Do you have to grease it any regardless? I mean, if it, what if it was pretty greased before?
That's why I say it. I clean it up. I clean the whole thing up. See? And
Oh,
then I
put new
just
grease in.
increase. Right. Because you don't want to have the dirt, all the grease with all the dirt. You know, because you can notice. You see, when you have grease that's used like this, you see it changes color and it gets blacker. So you want just have new grease in it.
What about that?
What?
That piece.
That one?
Yeah. What about
No,
that
that.
piece?
No, that one goes for on the. On the caliper. You see this part goes like that. You see the fitting part goes in towards the center. See? And then this part goes like that. See?
Now it's complete, I believe.
Now these ones are this is another spacer. You just gotta make sure that in your bike, you know, all bikes are gonna be different, so
I believe you gotta remember,
just
you know,
gotta
all the sequence that you put in out, and you know.
right. Just keep in mind the all the pieces that are gonna have that you have in your, you know, just keep track of all the spacers and all the, and even if you forget, what I did is I just went to the Suzuki website, and then they have all the specs there also. So if you don't know anything for sure, all you have to do is just go to the your manufacturer's website. And then check the plans. That's what I did. And you can even print them out. So you see the plans right there. So you see? We have that on. And we already greased the other side. You see? So Now we're gonna put it on. Okay, now as you can see, I have the old chain that I had on my bag before. It was already, you know, already too loose. So what I did, I tried to, I saw another videos that guys did. They tried. They usually had the master link, which was you know really easy to take out. But this one was riveted, so I had to cut it up. I just cut the, you know, used a regular, you know, saw. I just bought the blade for the, you know, to cut metal, and I just, you know, cut the hell out of it. So now I bought my new chain, is this one. I bought it on Amazon. It's usually for the 600 Katana F. It's mine's a 2004 600 GSX 600F. So usually the chain that I use is number 530. So I got this new chain, you know, all blue to match up my chain, my existing colors.
You should have gotten a more contrasting one, man. I told you.
Nah, shit it. Now, what I'm doing in here is all doing the same thing, just, you know, greasing up the. Usually, you use what most guys do is they use the regular wax, you know, for the chain. But you know, I don't really like to use the wax because it just doesn't, you know, last as much, and you have to keep, you know, spraying on it. So I use the same waterproof grate and grease because it's really good and it stays on the longest. So I'll just kind of smear it in. Actually, the chain came in already
waxed,
so that's pretty good. So, I can do. Okay, now just clean up the. We're gonna put back the rear tire. I'm doing just cleaning up the axle of the old grease. You gotta do is just, you know, go ahead and put some new grease in it.